Google recently released Android 11 Developer Preview 2 for its Pixel devices. But with the help of awesome developers, the same can be installed on OnePlus 6N 6T. So in this video, I'll be showing you how to install Android 11 Developer Preview 2 on OnePlus 6N 6T. So without further ado, let's get started. Here I have my OnePlus 6T, which is now running on the latest build of Oxygen OS, which is 10.3.2. Before installing Android 11 on your device, make sure to take a complete backup of your device, because in this process we need to unlock the device. My device bootloader is already unlocked. If you're not aware about unlocking bootloader, I'll give a direct link in the video description, and with the help of that video you can also install ADB drivers on your PC, which is required right now. So first you need to unlock your bootloader. Right now my device bootloader is already unlocked. Let me show you that. Going to developer options. So here you can see OEM unlock. I can't disable it now because it's already unlocked. Then enable advanced reboot and also enable USB debugging. All the download links will be available in the description below. And make sure to install ADB drivers on your PC. So I've already installed ADB drivers. Here you can see in my C drive, I have a folder of ADB in which I have subfolders of my different devices. Right now we are installing Android 11 on our OnePlus 6T. So here these are the files which are required. One is the partition resizer, second one will be the developer preview 2, which is based on Android 11, and third will be the TWRP recovery. So download these two zip files. Once you have downloaded, extract these two zip files, which is partition resizer and developer preview 2. Once you have all these things available, first you need to unlock the bootloader. If you guys are not aware about unlocking bootloader, a dedicated video is given in the description below. Next step is to boot your device into fast boot mode. So once you have enabled the advanced reboot option, press and hold power key. You'll get the option of booting into bootloader. Tap on that. After your device boots into fast boot mode, you can see the device state is unlocked if you guys have already unlocked it. If you guys haven't unlocked the device, I'll tell you how to unlock it. You need to go to the same folder, which is ADB. In this, you need to open command prompt. That can be done by typing CMD in the address bar and hit enter. Now you need to check whether your device is properly connected in fast boot mode or not. So for that, give a command fast boot devices and hit enter. If you see this serial number, that means your device is properly connected in fast boot mode. And to unlock, what you have to do is give a command of fast boot OEM unlock. Once you hit enter, a message will pop up on your device. Just select unlock bootloader, and later your device will perform a factory reset and you'll have bootloader unlocked. So as a device bootloader is already unlocked, now we need to flash the TWRP image. So here we have the TWRP image file. Copy the same name of the TWRP recovery, and here you need to give a command, that is fast boot boot followed by the recovery name. You can paste by right clicking and add .img because it's an image file. Now if you hit enter, your device will boot into TWRP recovery. And here you can see, now our device boots into TWRP recovery. Swipe to allow modifications. And now make sure that your device is on slot A. So here you can see my device's current slot is B. So we need to first switch to slot A. For that, tap on slot A. Hit the home button. Tap on reboot. Tap on bootloader. Now our device booted again into fast boot mode. So go to your PC and again give the same command of TWRP recovery. So the command will be same, fast boot boot, name of the TWRP recovery followed by .img. Hit enter. After booting back into TWRP recovery, go to reboot, and now you'll see current slot is A. Next step is to flash the partition resizer. So here we have the partition resizer. Unzip that, then you'll see these files. So here we have EPR remover for all the three variants, and this is for both OnePlus 6 and 6T. For example, if you have 64 GB, use this file. If you have 128 GB, use the second one. If you have 256 GB, then use the third one. So right now I have 128 GB variant. I'll copy this file and place it inside the internal storage. And if you see something like this and you are unable to copy the file, then what you can do is go to your device, go to wipe, format data, type yes, and hit this blue tick mark. Once it is done, tap on the home button, go to reboot, and reboot the bootloader. Now again you can give the same command to boot your device into TWRP recovery, which is fast boot TWRP recovery name followed by .img, and hit enter. So now we are again back into TWRP recovery. Tap on reboot and you should see current slot as A. Now you'll be able to copy the files to internal storage. So here we have the file which is for 128GB variant. Copy that and paste it inside the internal storage. Once it is done, go to install, select the file and swipe to confirm flash. Once it is successfully flashed, go to the main menu, go to wipe, format data, again go back, go to wipe, advanced wipe and select system from here, swipe to wipe. Once you are done with these two things, go to the main page, tap on reboot and boot your device to fast boot mode by tapping bootloader. After your device again boots to fast boot mode, go to your PC and in the same folder, inside command prompt, you need to give a command which is this one. So copy this command, all the commands are given in the description below, and paste it in command prompt. Hit enter and you will see a message setting current slot to A. So once this is done, now comes the main part in which where we'll flash the Android Q developer preview 2. Open this file if you have already unzipped. Before starting with the process, close command prompt and now double tap on clean flasher. This process might take around 10 to 15 minutes. Once it is done, your device will automatically boot into system having Android 11. And once this process is completed, it will hardly take 10 to 12 minutes. Once it's done, your device will automatically boot into system. So here you can see the boot animation of Android 11. Ignore this initial message, close whatever errors you are getting and you can complete the setup. And here you can see your device have been successfully booted up. Let me show you the software information by going to settings, about phone, under Android version is Android R, which is Android 11. Security patch has been updated to 5th March 2020. So guys, this way you can install Android 11 on your OnePlus 6 and 60. If you still have any kind of questions, you can let me know in the comment section below. This is your friend Ashok signing out. See you guys in the next video.